During the Google I/O conference 2015, Google announced 1.0 of Polymer, which marked a significant point in the development of the project. As you can see on the Polymer website, Google now considers the project to be production ready, and so we can go ahead and start to incorporate this into more of our real world projects. For those of you who don't know, Polymer is intended to be a standard development kit or SDK for the web platform, and it's not intended to directly replace other tools such as Twitter Bootstrap, for example, but it's instead intended to enhance the experience that those other toolkits can offer, as well as including a whole host of elements that you can use on your own website specific to Polymer, which take advantage of Google's material design principles. Many of these elements can be viewed on the Elements Catalog, which is Google's website specifically for elements, and it groups elements into different types. So for example, you can have core components which are stylized but not necessarily styled with the material design. All of the material design elements are all contained within this separate package, as well as other packages containing different types of elements, and we'll be looking at a couple of these in more detail later on. The first thing we're going to need to do, however, is to install Bower, which is how we actually get Polymer. If you click here, this video will guide you through the installation process of Bower, as well as giving you a brief overview of what it does and how it works. If you want to just get up and running with your project as quickly as possible, which you can use to install Polymer, but this of course doesn't take advantage of the advantages of using a package manager like Bower, for example keeping your project up to date automatically. So I've gone ahead and opened up a terminal window, and I'm just going to create a new directory for our project. And then because we already have Bower installed, we can simply type Bower in it, and we'll go ahead and initialize our new project. I'm going to skip through most of the details because we don't actually need to change anything, we just want to get a brief setup installed, which has created a bower.json file for us. And we can also use Bower to install Polymer for us. Before we do, however, we can type Bower info. On Polymer, and this will give us information about the latest installation, specifically the latest version, which as we can see is already 1.0.2. And so we can now go ahead and add this to our project, which we can do by typing Bower install Polymer, and if we add the save flag, it will update our bower.json file for us. This is obviously going to go ahead and download all of the components and install them into our folder for us. So if we look at the folder, we can see that we have bower.json and bower components, which contains Polymer and web components. So now that we have Polymer installed, we can go ahead and begin to develop our project. In the next video, we're going to be looking at development patterns, including all of the details that you're going to need to create your first Polymer-based project. So make sure you subscribe so you don't miss that.